What's up? This is Johnny Christ.
And this is the Rev of Avenged Sevenfold, and you're watching Artists in News. Well, we packed our bus with the techs and lighting guy and loaded up the trailer and somehow like with a bunch of state gear for the stage, like, and all the moving lights and shit, and like it's just crazy production, like compared to anything we've ever done before, and we threw more budget into it, you know,
spent a lot more money
and they pay you more, and we're basically taking everything they pay us and putting it into the show just to get it known that we have, you know, a superior live show.
Yeah, you know, we just always want to put on a new show for them, like give them something to come back to, you know, and not give them the same show every fucking time, you know. You got to do something different so that gives them a reason to buy the tickets and come back.
We just want to build up our touring as like the pinnacle, the focal point of our business, you know, as a band, so that, I mean, if we can get our touring big enough to where we're playing big enough rooms, and the money will be there, you know. That's the theory.
It's the ultimate goal.
We'll see if it works out.
Yeah.
If not, I quit. I will quit within a year.
I'll quit tomorrow.
You'll never see me again.
You'll never see these eyes again.
The best show I ever saw was, or recently the best show I've ever seen is Motley Crue and Iron Maiden. Iron Maiden, just the best, like,
the
live
best
band
live
ever.
Show ever. They have
the craziest live show I ever saw was like White Zombie, and they opened up for Pantera, but just their stage setting and everything is just unbelievable. It just blows you away, you know. We just want to be a live band like that. Like, whoa, that's who we grew up listening to and going to those shows, and that's the kind of band we want to be.
Yeah, well, like the first show, big concert I ever went to was Metallica on their Load tours, and they had the big stage. They're just running back and forth across, and just a whole theatrical show is going on as it's going, and that's something that's always inspiring.
It's like a science experiment.
Like, you one too, goddammit.
You know, it's funny. People at home are not going to know what's going on. They're just going to see.
Now they know, right?
Yep.
Getting the album done?
Working with Mudrock.
writing the songs. We took 9 months just writing in our garage. That's the only way we wrote. We wrote individually at home, and then we come in the garage and put everything together.
That always happens to me.
That just, like, once we got into the studio, Warner had our backs. They had the budget so we could bring in an orchestra to play with us on the record, and
boys choir.
Yeah, boys choir to sing, and like,
which I
we
really
got
enjoyed.
Andy Wallace to mix it. It's amazing, you know, like, just make it sound great, and just the writing, and like, we decided right from the beginning that we didn't care what, like, where it went. We were just gonna go wherever the writing took us, and just if there was something,
just
if there's something crazy or funny,
we just
leave it and.
The whole writing process, you just kind of got to have fun with, too, and let your influences just come out, and just let it come out naturally. You don't want to go in there and have anything come out forced or contrived.